Hello sir, good morning. It's me Vishal from B Practical. I had done my assignment that you have given to me. Now I'm going to explain about this assignment that what types of technology and features are used in this web application. So let's start it. Well, in this assignment, I use the technologies like React.js, CSS, Bootstrap, and I also use the React features like JSX, Component, JSON Server, Router, State, Ops, and Event. Before starting the project explanation, I told you one thing. Till now, only our React.js was completed. I don't have any idea about our backend part like Node.js or MongoDB. So, for storing the data purpose, I use our JSON server. Now, come to in our homepage. You can see that in our homepage we have a two section. First one is our navigation section. Second one is our banner section. So come to in navigation section, you can see that inside our navigation we have two parts. First, left side we have a logo and right side we have a menu bar. So, and our banner section, in our banner section you can see that we have a text and their images. So now I inform you one thing, you can see that our home component and about component both are same, only change their text and images. What I do, make a separate common component and I receive data from the both component using props. You can see that in our home component, I import my common component and I bind my our common component here. Using props, I can pass their name with the image path and their links. And same thing I do in our about section. You can see that I import my common component and bind my common component here, and using props I can send the data, and all this data we can receive in our common component. You can see that every change our component, it display the different data. Now come to in our navigation section, you can see that we have a navigation section, we have our menu bar. So user click any menu bar, it's displayed other data, it's display the different data. So it's possible by router. So come to in our app.js, you can see that our app.js, I import my all components here and I also import my all property of React router DOM, like browser router, switch, route, and redirect. You can see that I bind my router here, and inside the router I bind also my all React router properties like switch or route. So if you are use the route, then it's provide the two properties. One is a router consumer, one is a router provider. Router provider always is an input acceptor and router consumer is always response generator. You can see that in our route path, we can define here our path. So it's matched to our navbar path. I'll show you. It's match our navbar path. Here we define our navbar path. If both are matched, then our view will be component view. You can see that if it is matched, you can see that in URL bar, if it is matched, then our view will be component view. So come to in our another section, our services section. You can see that in our services section we have a three cards there. Each cards have different datas with different name with title. So what I do, I create a separate component for that. You can see that I import my all images here and I store the data as an array format inside our card data, and I export my card data, and this card data I receive my in services section. You can see that I import my card data here, and inside the card I use my map method. Map method is a JavaScript method. It's always accept the three parameters. First one is a current element, current index, and current array. But this here we don't need any our current array, so that we go through the only current element and current index. So you can see that in our, I bind my card component here and I receive the data, means our all data inside the value, and I receive the data from image.src, you can see that in our card component define the same name here, so that if it is match, then it's display the different data. Come to in our review section, you can see that in our review sections we have our input fields. So I show that destination review. You can see that here I import my Axios. Axios is always handle the network request like get, post, delete, put, and it's all handle our network request. And you can see that here I can used our class component. Inside our class component, I define my directly state. So constructor is always represent our class name, and super is always in refer our inherit component. So inside our constructor, I define my state, or every state data will be null, and this state I will directly assign into our value. You can see that this dot value dot email. So whatever user write here, and it will be set into our this state. And I can also here one event, it's called onChange event. Using this event, I update my state here. You can see that I update my state here. In same way, our username, our phone, and our country. It's our onChange event. Every change the event means every change that text, it will be triggered. The function will be triggered, and it will be update our all the data inside our state. Set state is used to update the data in our React. And come to the another section. You can see that here is our form. Yeah, you can see that sir here. I also write one function. It's a event on submit event. If form was filled and users hit on the submit button, then that function will be triggered and execute the all their blocks. So you can see that here I can use the Axios, and post method is always used to send the data. So I directly write our URL. You can JSON server URL. You can see that I can directly write our JSON server URL, and here I pass as a parameter my all state data. So if it is successfully received, then it's execute our done block. If it is not, means it's rejected, so it's execute our catch block. Means it's a promises. It's always in promises we have a part. First, if our data successfully received or post, then it will execute our then block. Otherwise, it will be execute our catch block. So come to in our cursor. I will show you, sir. It's how it's working. I hit on submit button, that function, our on submit function will be triggered. And here I can define it as alert data inserted, redirect my component to summary component. You can see that I hit on the submit button. Our data will be inserted. It will be redirected on our summary page. So in our summary page, I'll show you, sir. You can see that whatever data inside our JSON format data, you'll see that inside here. So how it's possible, I will show you. So you can see that in our here summary component, I also get our Axios. And here I can also write our class component, and here I can define one state. and state and there as a format, but it's right now it's null. You can see that our component did mount is our React lifecycle hooks. Component did mount always execute after the render method. So here we can just write our URL, and get method is always fetch the data from the web APIs. So inside our, if it is successfully received, then it will be execute our then block. Inside that then block, I will define one result. Inside the result, we have all data. So what I do here, I just update my that user blank data inside our result data. Means whatever we receive data from result.data, it will be updated in our users. And I also, here is a one facility, it's called the delete feature. If I user hit on the delete button, then it will be triggered and data will be deleted. If we refresh the web page, data will be deleted. So how it's possible, I will show you, sir. You can see that inside our for delete data, here I can also write the on click event, and every trigger that every deleting the data means every clicking the delete, it will be triggered and it's execute our this block. You can see that I can receive one event here, and I can also receive the user ID. Means user ID, you can see that I pass as a user ID. So whatever receive the ID, just delete the data. So it is the simple assignment, sir. So I hope you like it, sir. And thank you so much. And give me a chance to show my skills. And for that, sir, thank you so much.